Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 8, featuring Alan Ladd, William Conrad, Jimmy Durante, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
Hiya, babe. Say, how about... Ouch!
Does that answer your question, buddy?
The Adventures of Maisie, starring Ann Sothern. You all remember Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer's famous Maisie picture. In just a moment, you'll hear Maisie in radio, starring the same glamorous star you all went to see and loved on the screen, Ann Sothern. But first, your announcer. And now here's Ann Sothern as Maisie.
Yep, I'm Maisie, like the fella just said. Maisie Revere from Brooklyn. I love Brooklyn. When I'm away from it, I miss hearing that beautiful accent purring in my ears. And of course, I miss Eddie. Eddie Jordan's the good-looking, sweet-talking, lovable, lazy, no-good bum I'm engaged to. We're going to get married as soon as he gets a little money. But it's not easy because he's allergic to work. And too nervous to be a burglar. But it's nice to be back in Brooklyn in Mrs. Kennedy's room and house where we both live. If you can call it living. Eddie and I both have been looking for jobs. But when I come back, Eddie's always home before, sitting in the sitting room, taking it easy. Like now, for instance.
Hi, doll. How are you?
Don't ask me. I might tell you. What a day.
Oh, you look gorgeous, Dreamboat. Any luck today?
No. And, you know, I ought to have my head examined for going to see that psychiatrist. The things he expects of a receptionist. How about you?
No luck, Maisie. There wasn't anything at the Kelly Employment Agency, so I walked all over town looking for work.
Really, Eddie?
Sure, doll. You don't think I'd lie to you, do you?
Yes.
Oh, fine. Here I am beating my feet off to get a job so we can get married and settle down, and you accuse me of lying to you.
I don't know why I ever doubt you, Eddie. Except you're such a stinker sometimes.
I forgive you. Sit down right here in my lap, luscious.
Oh, Eddie, you're such a sweet guy, and I... Ouch!
What's the matter?
There's something in your vest pocket that's sticking into me. Let's see.
No, never mind. I'll get it.
Never mind. I've got it. It's a nice, fresh hunk of pool chalk.
Okay. So I was playing Kelly Pool today and got a hot tip and lost $10. But you ought to be ashamed of yourself for not trusting me.
Well, how can I trust you when you never tell me the truth?
So what? You gotta trust a guy anyway.
Oh.
I'm going to my room.
What a man.
Maisie, where are you, Maisie?
In the sitting room.
Oh. Gee, Maisie, I've been wanting to talk to you all day.
Oh. What's it about?
Oh, somebody who's very much interested in you.
You mean my boyfriend, Eddie Jordan?
Oh, no, I mean, your silent lover. Me, Merton Falsgruber.
Oh. Well, what's the trouble, Mike?
Maisie, can I ask you a frank question?
Everybody else does. Why should you be an exception? But I warn you, the usual answer to the usual question is usually no.
Well, Maisie, did you ever have the feeling that you were a little nuts?
No, but my friends get that feeling about me all the time.
No. I mean, did anything weird ever happen to you?
Constantly. Uh-huh. But never mind. What's your problem?
Well, Maisie, I've been bothered by dreams.
Blondes, brunettes, or redheads?
No, regular dreams. And they sort of come true. One night I dream about something, the next day it happens.
Oh. Give me a for instance.
Well, 2 days ago, I dreamt that your boyfriend, Eddie Jordan, would lose his job. Yesterday, he lost it.
Oh, that's not being psychic. Eddie's just running true to form.
Oh, and I dreamed that our landlady, Mrs. Kennedy, would get in a fight with her boyfriend on the way home tonight, but that hasn't had time to come true yet.
See, Merton, all you have to do is give Mrs. Kennedy a couple of days and she's sure to get into a fight with somebody. Now, I wouldn't worry about your dreams.
Well, I had another dream. I dreamt that you kissed me.
Merton. Huh? You're a real nice kid and I like you a lot, but that dream isn't coming true.
Oh, you might as well kiss me, Maisie. You're going to sooner or later. It's fate.
Hey, what's going on here?
Well, well, it's Merton, my competition.
Ah, your father's mustache.
Your sister smokes a pipe.
Your mother wears army shoes.
Boys, boys, what would think to hear you talk that you didn't come from families of breeding and culture, which you didn't.
Maisie, I came back to forgive you.
Well, thank you.
Tell me, what's this character trying to do, romance you?
Uh-huh.
Sure I was. At least I think I was.
So what else is new?
Eddie, aren't you even a little jealous?
Nah.
But he was making love to me.
So what, Maisie?
Hey, wait a minute.
Eddie, I'm talking about wild, passionate love. Get mad already.
Maisie, for gosh sakes, I don't want to get in a fight over some fun I never had.
Okay, so I was just kidding. But Merton here said he had a dream that I was going to kiss him.
Yeah, and my dreams have all been coming true lately.
That's impossible. Any fool knows that.
Okay, so you know it. I also dreamt that Mrs. Kennedy would get into a fight with a boyfriend this afternoon, but she hasn't got...
Susan, all the electricity in the sitting room.
Oh, it's Eddie and Merton and me, Mrs. Kennedy.
Oh, what's going on? Are you fellows changing shifts?
No, we're just talking.
Say, Mrs. Kennedy, can I ask you a personal question?
If it's about the plumbing in this house, my answer is no, I'm not going to buy a bigger water heater.
No, I think Merton wanted to ask how you were getting along with your boyfriend, Lester.
Oh, I'm not going to tell you. Oh, dear.
Why, Mrs. Kennedy.
Oh, gee, it doesn't look as though she had a fight, does it?
I guess you and Lester are getting along pretty well, hey, Mrs. Kennedy?
Yes, just beautifully. Today we had the most wonderful fight.
Huh?
It was so much fun making up afterward.
Hey, she had a fight after all.
Yeah.
Well, I wasn't going to let anybody call me a creaking old crow. Especially somebody I was deeply in love with. So I slugged him. He picked up a lamp and hit me with it, and I stuck his nose in the light socket. Speaking of lights, I'll turn these off in here.
Oh, it's dark.
Oh, well, I like it this way. Come here, baby. Give your Eddie a nice big kiss.
Eddie Merton's here.
Who cares about Merton? Besides, it's dark. Come on, love boat. Come to your dream boy.
Oh, Eddie, let go of me. Oh, all right. Here's just one kiss.
Hey, Maisie, you're not kissing me.
Huh? Well, I just kissed somebody.
Yippee! My dream came true.
Holy smoke. Maybe the kid's got something.
Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Merton.
Hello, Merton.
Drop dead, Merton.
Thank you. Gee, Maisie, I dreamt about you last night.
Well, I hope I come true. Say, do you know, Mrs. Kennedy, Merton dreamed night before last that you would have a fight with your boyfriend, and sure enough, you did.
Let me know when you dream about something more interesting.
And I had another dream, too. But this time, it was about a horse race.
Huh?
Who won?
Well, you know how it is at the races. Everybody was yelling and screaming, and, well, I couldn't hear very well. But the horse was called Dirty Shoes, I think.
Dirty Shoes.
Wait just a minute. I happen to know what's running today. The horses are called Dirty Neck, mm-hmm. Dirty Gertie, and Dirty Story. But there doesn't happen to be any dirty shoes.
Oh.
Well, that's a fine tip, Mike.
Well, come to think of it, that horse wasn't named Dirty Shoes after all. Huh. Now, I'm not sure what it was. Isn't that funny? Bye.
Oh, the poor kid.
What's the matter?
With a personality like that, he isn't going to live very long. Oh, boy, another murderous day.
I'm dead. I'm not used to this.
I know. This is the first time you've gone out to look for work that you've actually looked for work.
Honest, Maisie, I don't spend...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.